Ladies, hey guys.
No.
Hi guys.
Welcome to our channel. This is Adas Place and this is
Tammy Tamuno. Yeah. So guys, welcome back. If you're a returning subscriber and if you're new, welcome to our channel. On my channel, we talk about schooling abroad, living abroad, a little bit of travel and shenanigans. While on her channel, she talks about
things, living in Germany, studying here, how to get a visa, how to, you know, and even vlogs. So yeah, knowledge and tips in the midst of vibes.
That was the one I was waiting for. When there's tips, there's now knowledge, and then there's vibes. I don't know where else you're supposed to be. This is the place.
Yeah. And if you have not subscribed to our channels,
this is the time. Turn on notification for every time that we post a video, you will be notified. And we always bring you cool stuff. So trust me, you don't want to miss it. Yeah. So now let's dive into today's video. Mm-hmm. On today's video, since the year is coming to an end, we also know that application season is also coming to an end. A lot of people have already gotten their admission. Some people are moving for work. Some people are moving to meet their spouses. And some people are finally moving to school. So we'll be telling you about three important things that you need to come with you or to take with you when you're leaving Nigeria to any country in this winter.
Yeah.
And like we say three because they are in three categories and we expatiate on that. So if you want to write it down, get your notes, get your pen. If you feel like you will just listen and you'll be fine, that's cool. Grab your popcorn and let's dive right into it. Number one.
Before we even talk about number one, and this is not just for Nigerian viewers, for our viewers that are not also Nigerian. Mm-hmm. If you're living, I mean, you know, your
in
country
a humid
in Africa,
or temperate country, yes.
And you're moving to a country like in Europe or in America, places that are a little bit different when it comes to weather. Mm-hmm. And yours, this is very important for you to, you know, yeah. So, first things first, clothes. When it comes to clothes, of course, it's getting colder, right? Mm-hmm. So we need you to come with very thick jackets.
See, I did a hand like this. That's how it's supposed to be.
Very thick jacket. Not jeans.
Not jeans jacket. No coat. Monkey coat. No.
We need like jacket we had that has four inside. Mm-hmm. The kind of jackets that when you go to the market to buy, when you're in your temperate, you know, environment, and you go to the market, when you wear it, you're feeling hot.
Like you're about to suffocate.
That's
it
kind of
wants
jacket
to kill you.
The kind of jackets that have down feathers in it, like, you know, feathers inside, because these feathers insulate heat and it keeps you warm. And jackets that also have four wool inside, very thick jackets, right?
Yeah.
And another recommendation is that you should get a jacket a size bigger than yours.
Yes,
right?
One size bigger than your regular size. So if you wear a size L, then you should get an XL. If you M, you get L.
Yeah.
Because you get to wear sweatshirts or hoodies inside this, and it's already thick. So when you wear something that's your size, you look very proud. Like these are going to be.
Proud?
This was how I looked when I came to this country, and it was not cute.
Yeah.
I obviously look like a JJC. You don't want to look like you just came. Mm-hmm. You don't really want that to be the first thing people notice about you. So you
even
want to make sure
you're fine, but please your health. That is the most important thing.
Yes, and of course your drip. Drip is forever. So you want to drip properly. Please, dear, you want to drip properly. So make sure you get a size bigger than your regular size so that everything will fit and sit properly. Your Instagram people, you will pepper them. Your family members will think that you have won a lottery.
very, very important on the jacket. And something that's also very important too is to get like very thick trousers or thick leggings. That you
wear.
And this also goes to not just ladies, even for guys as well. Because wearing your jean during the winter, oh my goodness. You need these very thick leggings that has four
inside.
They usually wear during the winter. So when you wear this, it insulates your body. And then when you wear your jean trouser or whatever kind of trouser, like any material trouser you have, you don't feel too cold.
That's true.
And in addition to that, of course, socks, very thick socks. Not ankle sauce.
Sometimes beauty is supposed to be left aside. Focus on survival.
Focus on survival.
For winter, yeah, it's all about survival.
So make sure you
later
have...
you can do beauty when you have been in the country for a while and your body has gotten used to the weather. But first time, the cold that will slap you from the airport is enough for you to know that there's no jokes in this place.
Yeah.
So
and everything the thing about the cold here, the thing about the cold here is that it pierces the body. You get
yes,
it pierces the skin, so it's not like don't compare it to AC or you know, because the weather also fluctuates. Sometimes it could be maybe 16 degrees or what is even 16 degrees, maybe like 10 degrees, but it feels like -3 degrees, right?
It can don't be very... think that all the days and maybe your days going up to your departure date, you have been sleeping under AC, say you are preparing yourself, my darling, you are deceiving yourself. Prepare is not even the word, you are fooling yourself,
because even for us here, we're not even fully used to the weather yet. Like how much more
no one ever gets to the weather, like you never get used to the cold, you know it's coming, you're just more prepared, your system already understands sort of it, your system regulates and knows that at this time of the year it gets cold, so you're able to survive it. But it doesn't mean that you ever get used to the cold, because our body isn't made for this kind of cold. That's why you have this kind of clothes that are supposed to help us. So you make sure that you have all of the right things. You see those, your half-yard clothes, cupped up.
She said half-yard.
My darlings, leave it at home. You're going to shop for summer later. I wasn't told. I brought all my beautiful baby dresses and nice skirts. And when I came, I was like, am I going to use my half-yard? There was no room for using half-yard. And by the time it was summer and time to wear it, I started seeing that, this had, they are still checking, you know, when you go abroad, you start looking at abroad people's Instagram to know what they wear. I started seeing different things, and I started shopping for that summer. So it was like a waste of my time and my luggage space. Yeah. So don't bother bringing all those summer things. You don't need them. You will buy later.
Your abada, all those things. Mm-mm.
You're not coming here to go for Owambe. Leave it alone. Later, you can need it, but that's not what you need.
Yeah, that's not the most important thing right now. Yeah, and speaking of summer dress, speaking of winter dresses, of course, you have to come with shoes.
Yeah, thick shoes,
covered shoes,
no sandals, no rich auntie slippers. Leave it all alone.
Yeah, you need to have sneakers, ankle shoes,
ankle boots.
Yeah, ankle boots, those kind of boots that have four
inside.
Yeah,
That's what you need, honestly. Get those things. Those are the important things. And the reason why we're telling you to get is not because you don't sell these things here, but the truth is, when you come at first, you're still thinking in naira, and you don't want to spend 50 euros on a shoe, or 60 or 70, because of course it's in season, so it's expensive. When it's out of season, that there's like sales and it's cheaper. So when you now calculate it with your naira mentality, and you come and you're like 600 naira or 650 naira times 50 euros on top of one shoe, when I'm not using it to go for my wedding, do you get, it's too much for you. So it's just best to get it in Nigeria, where it's still cheaper, you're spending in the currency, and then you come prepared, you give yourself enough time before you start spending money on shopping while you're here. So that's why we're telling you these things, it's very 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 important. Then moving on to section two of
number two on the list
of the constitution. Section two of the constitution.
Did you study law? Did you ever study law?
No, but my mom said that I would have been a great lawyer.
You look at someone that, like, as I'm thinking, I know you studied economy, but then I'm like, are you sure it's not
economy? Are you sure it's not? Yeah, I know. Right? Another career path for another time of my life, because not this one. This one, school are finished. Not this one. In the another life.
Anyway. Okay. So, category number two, we're talking about documents now.
Bam.
You know, all the documents you use in applying for your application here, your school application, even your work, when it even comes to your, your birth certificate, your local government certificate, everything.
That you own. Every legal document that has your name on it, that you used to apply, or that you just have that can represent you or prove something about you. Pack everything, every original, maybe one set of photocopy, but you can always photocopy when you come here. That's not
you
the
don't
point.
You need a set of photocopy.
Carry all your original, honestly, because you never know what you're going to apply for when you come here. Maybe you're going to apply for a residency in another country. Maybe you're going to apply for a tourist visa in another country.
Yeah.
Maybe you're going to apply for some type of, you know, job that might want to do some background check and ask you for certain documents from your past life. different things. You don't know what you might need. So instead of having to call home and tell somebody to ship down your documents, they'll probably cost about 30,000 naira to send down to you, depending on the country that you live in. It's just best you have it, so you don't have to bother anybody. And trust me, you don't want to start telling someone to go and meet a lecturer or go to your school to get something for you, because that whole process is unnecessary when you can actually go there, get it yourself, and keep it for when you would use it.
Yeah.
So get everything that you can get. Everything.
Even your affidavits, court attestations, all these things. Get everything at once. Yeah. And speaking of documents, something that's also very important is a driver's license. If you already have a driver's license from your home country and you come to a country like Germany, for instance, you can easily change your driver's license within the first 1 year that you're here. And changing your driver's license doesn't necessarily mean you should already, you know, start driving, or you want to already start driving. You can just change it and keep it. Then when you're ready to drive, you drive. Because if you don't do this and you stay longer than a year, you start the process of getting the driver's license all over again. And it's very expensive, very time consuming. Getting an appointment in this country,
it takes about a year to get a driver's license. I'm like, this is one thing that nobody told me when I was coming, because I did have a driver's license, but I just felt, okay, I'm not driving in Germany. There's no need. Whenever I'm ready, I'll get a driver's license in Germany. I didn't even know. It was until later, after my driver's license had expired, a friend told me that even when you come during your first year, you can drive with that driver's license for 6 months without having to use a German driver's license before changing it. I didn't know. So now I have to go through the whole process all over again, which takes about a year. This is something that no one told me. So now you have this information, make good use of it.
If you're also going to an EU country, I mean, any driver's license you get in an EU country, you can use in other EU countries, right?
Which is
so
good.
It's very important. I'm moving forward to the last category on the list, food.
My darlings.
The reason we're talking about food is because we're not saying there's no food in you know, the country or destination country, but for people that are very inclined or very, you know, serious about African food, you've not tasted any other kind of cuisine, or you've not tried, you know, something else.
You're not very adventurous with food.
Exactly. Or even if you had, maybe your body didn't adjust to it and you're purging and all that. It's very important for you to already start with the food you're already used to. And getting food here, of course, if it's the food of the locals, it's cheaper. But if it's like, you know, certain Asian food or, you know, African food, it's usually more expensive, right? And then coming to spend that money you already have, they're supposed to use to clear some of your debts on food, when you can get something that you can already survive on from your home country. I mean, calculate it, right? So it's very important for you to come with some of this. And so sometimes, even if you can buy or you can afford some of this food here, the quality might not be the best. See, for instance, palm oil. There are a lot of African shops here in Berlin, for instance, that, you know, sell palm oil, but it's usually not the best quality, right? And it's rare before you find very good palm oil.
Palm oil is useless.
It's very rare before you find
palm oil outside of Nigeria, in any of these European countries, is useless. Trust me, it is so, so different. We just use the ones that we have here because that's what we have. Because we don't have another option. If not, like, I never knew about this whole palm oil thing. If I knew, like, in fact, just hearing it now, I'm very sure that anybody that's come from Nigeria is going to bring me a truckload of palm oil.
Honestly.
Because, like, it's so, so bad. And you're just like, well, this is what we have. We have to survive on this. I didn't know, because I also thought that palm oil was banned.
No, it's so... actually, speaking of palm oil and, you know, it being banned, the thing is, when you're coming, usually they don't allow liquid stuff, right?
Yeah.
However, the way you package it, right? So what you would do is to freeze it, you know, make sure that the oil is frozen, then wrap it so well, like, not because if it spills, it soils, you know, your box and everything. So you have to make sure you wrap it so well with paper, nylon, newspaper, everything. Wrap it very well and then put it at the very, you know, the bottom of your box.
Knowledge. Tips in the midst of that. Who did you ever know about this thing? Because I didn't know. And oh my gosh, I didn't even know.
Each time I travel home, I come back with palm oil. It's funny that I managed to travel, and then most of my friends are like, they still there at the airport and all. Yeah. I'm like, yeah, I can't be mine.
Honestly, like, use this tip if you want to, because trust me, it's the best thing that you can do for yourself. So use it. Pack all of your dry stuff, wrap it properly.
Sun dry, you know.
Sun dry. Make sure, because when you keep it in your box, I don't know how many hours it's going to take to get to your country destination. So it could go bad if you don't dry it properly and you don't pack it the right way. check on online, you could see like how it's being wrapped with like newspaper, and then you put them in Ziploc bags and you can tag them so you know what is what. Just pack them like that very, very well. You can do the trick of one luggage for clothes and one luggage for food.
Yeah.
Because the truth is, you don't want to start spending so much money on food when you come here, because the regular food is cheap. But the fact that you have to go to an African shop, it also depends on the city you live in. If you live in a very small village or small city, you might not find an African store, which means that you, the only time you'd have access to African shop is if you go to another city, or if you know someone that's coming from another city, which if you're not very adventurous with food, you don't want to do that. So it's just best to come with your own food. Again, you're not spending in euros just yet, or you're not earning in euros just yet. So example, a carton of Indomie is like 12 euros. So if you start, when you come over, so you're still calculating things in there, and then you calculate and be like, why is Indomie this expensive? And the small one.
Yeah, so it's not in the super pack size.
Pack your Indomie, because when you come here, you'll now be like, the Indomie, like when I came at first, I went to the store to buy Indomie, and it was written in German. I'm like, my real Indomie can never be written another language, so I'm not buying this. And I refused to buy it. I'm like, until I see Indomie that's written in English. I didn't buy that Indomie until I tested. I actually found Indomie. Like they have Indomie, two, weirdly. They're the ones that they wrote in English and the one they wrote in German. When I said, no, this Indomie can never taste the same because it is not written in the language that I understand.
Yeah.
So you don't even want to start giving yourself that hassle. Just the best thing for you to do is just come with all of the stuff that you need. Then you can gradually, you know, transition into eating the food that's available here.
Or even buying stuff yourself.
Exactly. Because for someone like me, I reacted a bit to the food, even though I'm not the kind of, if it's not Nigerian food, I'm not going to eat kind of person. I'm always very adventurous with food. I knew I wasn't going to have problems with food, but the consistency at which I was eating, it was now normal. Before, when I was in Nigeria, it was more like once in a week or once in 2 weeks, I go to a restaurant, I eat the weirdest things. But then now it was like my everyday life. Today I'm eating potato made like that's looking like this. Tomorrow I'm eating rice that twisted. Do you understand? My body couldn't understand it too. I was suffering like indigestion, I was bloated, like, it took a while before my body understood that, see, this baby is going to continue eating this rubbish.
So you better adjust.
Let's adjust. So to make yours easier, like the transition easy, you mix it up. You have your Nigerian food, you eat Nigerian food here, you eat this other food, and then your body will slowly understand that things on my life don't change. So yeah.
Yeah. And one last tip. I mean, we said
bonus.
Just one last tip. Of course, is as a lady, come with your hair extension, come with your wigs, because the weather is not great for our hair. It dries it over, and then it just shapes the whole thing off, right?
So you need to protect your scalp. Your hair will start from here. By the time winter is over, hair starts from the middle. It will cut, it will make you go bald. Guys too that keep their hair, this is very important. If not, you will go bald.
So yeah, you need to come with your hair products, come with your hair extensions, come with your wigs, come with your beanies
because you need to cover your hair. In summer, you can be adventurous with your hair, but protecting your hair is very important in winter because it is very, very aggressive on your hair.
Yeah, and even
if that's my own, it's gone. I have no more hair.
Even if it's not, you know, winter, I mean, here to get, to find a salon is difficult, and if you do find one, it's quite expensive, right? So before you get, and even also if you don't even know how to make your hair yourself, because it's
one thing YouTube videos on how to make your hair yourself
and learning how to make yourself. So
start watching YouTube videos to learn how to make your hair yourself if you want to save money.
Yeah,
because I did save a lot of money. For the last 3 years I've been in this country, I have not paid a dime for anyone to make my hair, because I learned how to make my hair myself. No one told me. I was just doing it.
You just
like when I was in Nigeria, I didn't even think far like that, and I'm very grateful that I learned. If not, do you know how much people spend over 200 euros for a hairstyle that would not last you for more than 1 week? Because the people here are very annoying. You know how in Nigeria they take their time, and then they like the way they will cut the hair, like line it and everything and make it neatly. You can carry the hair for like 1 month. Here, that same style, somebody would make you cannot carry for more than 1 week. It's like they're in a hurry. Do you get, because it's, they kind of like look at the hour that they spend on your hair. In Nigeria, they just take the amount of money you pay them for the hair, no matter how long you would take. But here, they are cautious of the time they are spending on your hair, so they don't put in as much effort. Yet you're paying so way more than you would normally pay. Yeah. So if you can learn how to make your hair yourself, better for you. Just keep watching YouTube videos. I'm sure it's out there, people who do like all this hair content. Learn how to make your hair yourself so you can save yourself all that money.
Yeah. Anyway, guys, this is the end of this video. We hope you really like it. We hope that we were able to, you know, teach you
important points.
Tell you some things that are very important. I mean, if we had this kind of information, it would have made our lives a lot easier when we were coming.
I would have not carried half yard all the way from Nigeria to this place when I wouldn't need it.
This has made our lives a lot easier. That's why I give you this information. And you know, in order to keep our channel going, please subscribe to our channel.
Yes.
Like this video.
Tell us everything in the comment section. Yeah, what you like. If you have more points for people who are about to travel, please tell them in the comment section.
Yeah.
If you have specific questions on what to carry and what not to carry when traveling, write all of them in the comment section and we would respond to you as soon as possible.
Yeah, and also follow us on our social media handles on IG and stuff. You're going to see our, you know,
Purple Times, Adas Place.
You're going to see it on the screen as well.
And everything about studying abroad, also check out Purple Book NG. Purplebook.ng is the website. The Instagram name is Purple Book NG.
Yeah. So that's about it.
We're done. Come on, we're going to your house.
And yeah, from the both of us, we wish you safe travels.
Welcome abroad. Welcome. We wish you all the best. Yeah. We hope that you enjoy your stay and you make very good use of this opportunity because a lot of people need it.
Yeah.
So make good use of it. Have fun. Take all the Pepe Dem pictures and send to your family members because you have landed.
How we started and how it is now.
All right, guys. Take care of you. Testing, testing. Say 1-2. 1-2.
So we say 5 tests. Those 5 sets.
This is take 50. Let's not talk too much. Right now, I've used all my thoughts.